Thank you. How many people have seen the movie? How many people have read the book? Well, a lot fewer, but it's been out of print for a while, so I was supposed to have some for this, but they're going to be coming here in a few days. And rather than trying to go point by point with where the movie strayed from what really happened, I'll just tell you what happened. It was November 5th, 1975, 34 years ago. It was a Wednesday. There were seven of us out there. In the movie, they had just five. The slide's actually a little larger than that, showing all six of the other guys. Anyway, we got the crew boss, Mike, Ken Peterson, Dwayne Smith, John Gillette, and the two that you can't see there are Alan Dallas and Steve Pierce. And like me, 34 years later, all of these guys stand by their story. You know, what happened, happened. And it was a work day. We just finished long, hard day cutting trees, and it was starting to get dark, and we all got into this crew cab truck, you know. So that's how seven of us fit into this truck, three in the front, four in the back. And we're driving down this rough dirt road out of there, and we saw some lights coming through the trees, just little glimmers at first. Nobody was really particularly alarmed when we first saw it because it was deer hunting season, and you know, occasionally we'll see hunters or campers out. And so, as the closer we got, the stranger it seemed, because it was coming from above where I figured the top of the ridge would be, little glimmers coming through the trees. Just, you know, a map here of where it happened on the rim. A lot of people don't know that there's quite a bit of forest in Arizona. So when we finally got around the trees to where we could see it, there was kind of a break, an opening there, and there this thing was, you know. It was just unmistakable. It was Alan Dallas yelled out, "It's a flying saucer," right off the bat, because, you know, the skeptics were trying to say, "Oh, they just saw the planet Jupiter off in the sky or something." But there was no mistaking. This was a metallic object hovering in the sky there, less than 100 feet away. But so many times when we've been you know, in the woods and we'll catch sight of an animal, you know, you say, "There goes a bear, there goes a deer," you know. By the time the rest of the guys look, it's almost gone, you know. So that's kind of the impression I had here, that, you know, it was just going to take off. And so I jumped out of the truck and started towards it, thinking it would be gone before I got close. And what I was doing really alarmed the other guys, and they started yelling and screaming at me to get back in the truck. And I pretty quickly started having second thoughts about what I was doing myself, and I slowed down, and I didn't want to look foolish, and so I made myself continue on. We could hear the rumble, the sound that it was making. It was a kind of a mixture of sounds, some very, very high-pitched and some very low rumbles. I think probably off the range of human hearing on both ends of the spectrum. But they were just screaming and yelling at me to get away from there. And, you know, that part of the movie was pretty accurate. At one point, you know, I got to where I was looking up at an angle, a pretty steep angle at it. I couldn't really get in much closer because there was a big pile of logging debris there. But I was standing there, and it suddenly started to move. It rose up a little, not real steady. It was kind of an unsteady motion, and the sound got louder, like it was powering up. It was real, you could feel it as well as hear it. And that scared me, so I jumped down behind the end of a log that was sticking out of this pile of debris, and those guys were really frantic at screaming at me to get back in the truck. And I didn't need them to tell me that. I was thinking, how am I going to, get out of here? I felt, a little safer hiding behind the log, but I wanted to get. So I was thinking I would raise up and take off, just make a sprint back to the truck. But when I raised up, I just felt this shock go through my body. It's kind of like an electric shock. Or if you've ever been hit real hard when you didn't see it coming, that's the way it felt, and I just blacked out. But the guys in the truck said that a bolt of energy came out of the bottom of this craft and hit me in the upper body, and it threw me back through the air. I said it just looked like a grenade going off. The force of the blast. One of the guys, Dwayne Smith, he said that, later he became an electrician, and he said he's worked around high voltage. To him, it sounded really electrical, like a lightning bolt or something. But in the police report, the deputy that interviewed Ken Peterson, he said he described it as looking like a long blue flame. But, whether it was a beam or a lightning bolt or whatever, they thought it killed me. They said it threw me back through the air and my body hit the ground limp and dust boiled up around me. And they just knew they were next, And so they panicked and left. And those guys have gotten some criticism for fleeing, but I got to say I can't blame them, in the situation that they were in. First of all, they thought I was dead. What good would it do to get themselves killed, if it already killed me? Somebody yelled out it killed him, everybody was telling the boss let's go, and I don't think he needed to be told. They drove and almost wrecked the truck getting out of there. But they did what they had to do. It was really the smartest thing to do. They had no weapons, and so they took off, and they went as soon as they got to where they put some good distance between them, they stopped and they got out, and they said they were just all kinds of screaming and yelling, trying to decide what to do, and they started to build a fire, and I guess they didn't actually build a fire, but I think what happened was a deer hunter went by out on the rim road, and so one of the guys suggested they chase them down and see if they could get help, somebody with some guns. And so they tried that, and they weren't able to catch up with them. So finally, Mike and Ken were saying, we've got to go back and see if we can help them. And some of the other guys said, no way, we shouldn't go back there, that's too dangerous. But unlike in the movie where they got out to stand alone in the dark, these guys aren't going to do that, they at least felt safer, being in the truck. They all went back, not just Mike, like in the movie. So I got to hand it to them for having the courage to do that, to, figuring that the responsible thing to do was to try to rescue me and see if maybe I had survived what happened, and if I needed help, they were gonna try to do something. So, although I've kind of had some rough times with some of the guys, especially the crew boss, about that, because my family, sort of condemned them for not being more heroic immediately. I got to give them credit that was a very brave thing to do, to go back that night and try to help. They did make a search. They were unable to find me, and so then they went back to town, and they had quite an argument about what to do.